coverage of the NFL has us on the west coast of the Sunshine State. Downtown Tampa's the spot, Raymond James Stadium. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Baltimore Ravens and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Now the Buccaneer offense gets set to take over. First play, first pass for Brady. And he's got the hook up here. It's Kyle Rudolph. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Right away, they rack up 10 yards on their first play from scrimmage.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play. And that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
On second and 9, Brady. A pass underneath for Fournette, and he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
Throwing is Brady on third down. And he goes down. The Ravens able to get to him. JPP cruising in for the sack that time.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board.
And he'll get this away into the humid Florida sky. And a fair catch called for and made just inside the 35-yard line. It's just a 32-yard punt with no return. And the Ravens, they'll take over. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at the 34. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He's got his man. It's Andrews.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Line of scrimmage, the 36 on second and 8. And now some motion before the snap. And this will be our first penalty of the night's proceedings. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Jackson on the give to Dobbins. Gets around him. And he'll get this up to about the 40. A sizable gain there, 9 yards as they get it back to a 3rd and 5.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
Open man is Duvernay. And he'll be touched out here, but not before he does pick up the first. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10.
The quick feet by Jackson. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. A good chunk on the ground on the keeper, 17 yards, first down.
And this, I mean, it's certainly something to watch out for. He is not afraid to call his own number on plays like that, and here he takes it for good yardage.
And we know this defense prepared all week for this, but sometimes when you see it in person, it's a whole different ball game, and all that preparation, it goes right out the window.
Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
And a lot of times, these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Here's the option going left on second down. Only a yard there on the keeper, and that's going to leave him with a third down.
Typically on the read option play, when we talk about responsibilities, we're talking about what the quarterback has to go through. How about the inside linebacker, though? His job on this play, shadow the quarterback and hold him to a short gain, did it to perfection.
Jackson looking to throw on third. Yeah, he's now the ball comes loose, and it's picked up by the Buccaneers.
Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football, and they still find ways to knock it free.
Second down, here's Fournette. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. He winds up giving a yard back there, and now it's third and two.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
The Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on third. To throw, it's Brady. And this one held in by Rudolph. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage.
Well, that one hurts. I mean, it was third down, of course, but now the penalty, and we're back to first down.
Yeah, it hurts momentum in a big way, and they built that up here in the early going. Now, that leaves the opposition with a first down. That's a mistake you don't want to make at this point in the game.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, first and 10. Now a play fake, Brady.
They'll swing this out to Fournette.
And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And that's going to bring up second down.
We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
First catch there for Evans, good enough for a first down.
John Harbaugh never shy about bringing out the red challenge flag, and he'll do so here.
Fournette, a first down carry. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
Nice chunk of yards on first down. It really opens up your options for what you want to do on second. You go right back to him and hope he explodes or sucker the defense in before throwing over the top.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. Again, it's Fournette, and he's going to be down close to a first down at the Ravens 35.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Play
number 7 coming on this drive. It's 3rd and inches. Here's Brady to throw. Throw left side complete. That's Evans. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
Yeah, they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up. Up the gut, Fournette. And he'll power ahead, but only for about 3 yards. 2nd down coming up.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be. But still, all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on 2nd down.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Inside handoff now to Fournette. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a 3rd down. No score after 1 on EA Sports. 2nd quarter now in Tampa Bay. It's the Buccaneers in control of the football as they've got it with a 3rd down coming up. Brady now to throw. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
They went with a dime look on defense. 2 extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
So Brady departs, and on is Ryan Succop for the Buccaneer field goal. They'll spot it at the 30, so this is a 40-yard attempt. Succop's kick is good, and the Bucs take a 3-0 lead. So the defense are able to force their first turnover of the game, and then they add on to that by getting the field goal.
And you don't just want to take the ball away from your opponent, partner. You want to make them hurt as well. And if you don't score yourself on defense, turn it over to your offense and have them put points on the board.
The Bucs ready for the kickoff. And here we go. It's in the air. No run back here for Duvernay. Touchback out to the 25. Baltimore set to take over here for their 2nd possession of the game. They fumbled the last time they had the football. Fortunate that it only led to a field goal. 3-0 the score as they start 1st and 10. And they'll begin by running the option. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
Play action. Now Jackson. He's got his man downfield. It's Robinson. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That goes for a gain of 31.
This offense has been slow to get started, but that play will certainly give them a little bit of life. Maybe the late wake-up call that they had been seeking.
So the big play gets them across midfield now for 1st and 10. On 1st and 10, it's Dobbins. And he is going to lose yardage here. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on 2nd down and 11. Now Jackson. He's able to find Wallace.
And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line.
Jackson to throw. Throw right side is complete to Andrews, his tight end. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted, but I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yep.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists.
Well, and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason. Field goals, all we've had so far. 3-3 now as the kick is away. Fielded right around the 8. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. So out come the Bucks now. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Calais Campbell on the stop.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again 2nd and 10. Here's Brady. This is caught by Evans. 30. 10. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Mike Evans, 82 yards. And the Bucs have moved out in front. And Charles, I had an offensive coordinator tell me one time that they design every play to score. I don't know how true that is, but he had to run a long way after that catch. Heck of a play.
I think that when he was telling you that, he was designing run after catch in every play. I mean, that's the only way to put it in there, and that's what we got on that one. Nice catch, an even better run for big yardage.
The Bucs ready for the kickoff. And here we go. It's in the air.
Duvernay going to sit on this in the end zone, so it'll come out to the 25.
And now Baltimore gets set to take the field.
Just a lone field goal for them so far, trailing 10-3 as they come up 1st and 10.
Jackson slings it to Andrews, and it's complete. The tight end has it. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he was unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and 5. Throwing is Jackson. A quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time. Separation. That's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
The offense on third down tonight. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. Now it's Jackson. They set up the screen for Dobbins. Good contain, no gain on the screen, and it'll bring up 4th down.
And I know that one didn't work out the way they thought, but I don't think it was a bad time to call this play. You're thinking on 3rd down, you might possibly see some pressure. You might see a blitz. So they tried to set up the screen, but that one was well read, and they stopped them for no gain.
4th down, and out comes Jordan Stout here to punt. Taken from just outside the 30. 35 yards that time on the punt, and the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. They're starting to pull away with this one. Early on that first quarter, they didn't look so great offensively. What has changed?
Sometimes it's just a matter of doing what you plan to do better. Sometimes you just put that all together and you execute. Other times it's just in a simple adjustment in your game plan, finding a spot that maybe was a little weaker than maybe you thought, and going to that. So many different things, so many different ways, but right now, you gotta like what they're doing. They have put distance between themselves and their opponent.
Looking to add on here in the second quarter. On 1st and 10, here's Brady. Into the hands of Darden.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Now a 2nd down and 6. They fake the handoff. Now Brady. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a 1st down. Well done. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Evans' 1,000-yard streak to start his career remains intact and is now at 8 years strong. And in his 8th season, came a career-high 14 touchdown catches as well. Another similar season, and Mike Evans will cross the 10,000-yard milestone this year. Easy first-down pickup for the superstar wideout.
And a strong run there as he'll maneuver his way down inside the 15. They'll get 13 yards for the 2nd play in a row.
They're making it look easy out there. Another 1st down. So far in this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 1st downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. Here's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line. Into the red zone, it's Brady. He'll check this one off to Fournette. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a 2nd and just a few inches left.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
On 2nd and inches, Brady toward the pylon, caught, touchdown, Jalen Darden, a 5-yard touchdown, and the Bucs go up by 2 touchdowns. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the 2nd quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the 1st quarter, now they find the end zone again here in the 2nd. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. No run back here for Duvernay. Touchback out to the 25. Baltimore about ready to go on offense.
It's been very much a slow start for them. Three drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is one. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
On first and 10, it's Jackson. That's into the hands of Prochet. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. Jackson trying to hustle his unit up quickly to the line of scrimmage. Now Jackson looking to throw on second down. He gets this underneath to Dobbins. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That one good for 13 and a Raven first down.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
Meanwhile, Jackson's throw into the hands of Andrews. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Jackson will throw again. That one complete to Prochet. And the tackle going to be made at the 38.
Partner, you know when we call a game, we talk about Lamar Jackson and his speed and his elusiveness and the ability to get him on the ground and how tough that is for a defense. But how about his development as a thrower, as a professional?
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Jackson. He's going to let this one go deep. And incomplete on the deep ball. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10. To throw is Jackson. That's complete. It's Rashad Bateman. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 28. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get 3 before halftime. He made his first attempt, this from 45. Tucker's kick is good. And a second field goal here gets him back within 11 now. It's 17-6. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with 3.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal. Not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
So 6 seconds, all that remains of this first half as the kick is away. This will be fielded inside the 5. One more drive here for the Buccaneer offense in this first half. And they'll have time for one play. There's 2 seconds on the clock.
Hey,
So time perhaps for one final kneel down before they take this lead to the locker room. He'll take the knee, and the final couple seconds will tick by in this first half. So we've hit halftime here in Tampa with the Bucs out in front. As we toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, it's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report from the six. And he returns this to the 22. The Raven offense set to start this third quarter. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
It was Jamel Dean who came up to make the tackle.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
From the 25 on second down, Jackson. And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front.
They certainly thought they had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Here's Jackson. The ball comes out, and it's picked up by the Buccaneers. So it's kind of more of the same offensively. This was a team needing to come out of this third quarter with a little fire. Instead, they put the ball on the ground.
And you know that has to be the discussion at halftime, because they're down two scores. We got to come out a little bit more urgency than we had in the first half. Now that urgency falls on their defense, because they can't fall down three scores and hope to come back and win this game.
Here's a give to Fournette. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
On first down, Brady. He completes it to Evans. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. It's a gain of 13 for number 13, and it gives them a first down.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover, and they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
They'll try and run for it with Fournette. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4.
That's good power football on first and goal. A lot of teams will throw from there, but that's a nice job to chew up a few more yards and get yourself closer to the goal line.
Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown. Tampa Bay. Russell Gage from 4 yards out, as his guys have opened up a very comfortable lead.
Partner, they had a good lead as they went in at the half, and they came out here in the second half and found a way to extend it. I love their consistency. Don't worry about what they said at halftime. This seemed like a team that was ready to play 60 minutes, and while this game is far from over, I love their approach.
The Bucs ready for the kickoff. And here we go. It's in the air. Takes it at the 7. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. The Baltimore's offense set for this next possession. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get 2 more possessions.
And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
If they want to start getting back into this game, it behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive. They'll break the huddle, come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line. Jackson with a handoff to Dobbins on the option. And he's going to be down at the 35, gain of 7.
He's had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. They'll try and pick it up by running the option to the lane. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. So that was all you're looking for on a play like that. Get the first down and keep the drive moving.
Yeah, it just looked to me like he just said to himself, I've got this. I'll take it. I'll pick it up and let's keep moving. Get the first down, get a new set, and let's start over.
Again, Jackson will keep it. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. That time they pick up a 24 yards on the keeper. First down.
Well, I tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react, even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL. They're still a little bit in disbelief and realize, oh my goodness, he's running with the ball. He may be 8, 10, 12 yards downfield at that point.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. 2nd down. That ground game contained again there, Charles, and that's really a big reason that they're trailing right now.
And give a lot of credit to that defensive front. That's exactly what they worked for all week, to try and take away the run game, make them one-dimensional. In the battle of game plans, theirs has been superior.
Now Dobbins again on 2nd down. And he'll be taken down at the 33, a pickup of about 4. Another modest gain there on that one. And I think, Charles, you can probably pin part of the deficit on a failure on their part to really get this ground game established.
Yeah, they've really struggled to be multidimensional in this one, haven't they, partner? Because they have to be extremely one-dimensional now if they hope to get back into this game. They'll have to do it by throwing the football and hope to have success through the air.
And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. That gain of 9 buys them a new set of downs.
But they're getting ready to go to work now in prime real estate after that last run. Found his spot and picked up nice yardage, didn't he?
And now he's got him knocking on the door of the red zone. All runs on this drive so far. It's 1st and 10. They go play action now. Jackson toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
The 2nd and 10 now as we roll along in the 3rd quarter from Tampa. They'll run up the gut with Dobbins. And they'll get a couple here down to the 22.
We know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy sometimes. Having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Yeah, every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. On 3rd down, Jackson buying time to his left. The quick feet by Jackson. He'll head out of bounds inside the 10, marking down at the 9. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first.
Oh, man. Just when the D thought they had the answer for him, he went and changed the question. surprises him by taking off himself, is able to set up his offense pretty with a first and goal.
They'll run with Dobbins. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. J.K. Dobbins, a 9-yard touchdown run. And the Ravens get a bit closer.
Well, they had their chances in the first half, you remember, but had to settle for 2 field goals. This time, they come away with 6.
I think they actually got affirmation about what they were doing by getting a touchdown, because the field goals means they got in range but couldn't quite finish it off. This time, they broke through, and that's great for the old confidence.
And on the sideline, difference of a feeling between 3 and 6, is it astronomical or no?
It can be at times, that's for sure. A lot of times, the field goal feels like a disappointment. The touchdown, well, that tells you you're getting it done.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. Their lead down to 2 scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a 1st and 10. From the gun, it's Brady. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's 2nd down. To give you an idea of how accurate he's been throwing the football, we're in the second half. That's just his 2nd incompletion.
Well, if he's that locked in, that means everyone's locked in, because to me it's like throwing a no-hitter in baseball. The pitcher may get the credit, but a lot of people making plays behind him in the field.
Brady's throw taken in by Evans here. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Throwing now is Brady. And Jones has it over the middle. And he is going to have the Buccaneers 1st down by about 3 yards or so as they wind up getting 7 there on 3rd and 4.
And that one was a lot of fun right there, because that was the game within the game. 3rd and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a 1st down.
Brady now on 1st down. And Rudolph has it, the tight end. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And they'll be left with a 2nd and about a foot.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
On 2nd and very short, Brady. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a 1st down. Well done. So both teams trade touchdowns, and the 3rd is worth through 3 quarters of play. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. So in Raven territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 39-yard line. Brady's got his guy. This is Gage. And he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense, because to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
Again, they'll throw with Brady. Looking for Godwin, and he's got him complete. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16.
But when you're up by 2 scores in the 4th quarter and you're going to throw the football, expect to see a lot of man coverage, because usually what comes along with man coverage is pressure. So if you're a play caller and you want to keep throwing the football, that's fine. Just make sure your offensive line understands they're going to get additional guys running at the quarterback.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. He's got Otten. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days. But you can flex him out. You can run wide receiver routes with him. You can make him a primary target. And that's how he'll shred a defense.
3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
The Bucs on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3. Here's Brady to throw. And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucs. The 4th touchdown pass of the game for Tom Brady.
And the Buccaneers have put this one to bed here in the 4th quarter.
A partner, he has carried them in this ball game, throwing the football, all 4 touchdowns through the air, and that's really helped them get this nice lead.
And I know it's a team game, but right now he is truly the focal point. Every touchdown his team has so far has been the result of his arm. How about him throwing it down to including big plays? I don't know how you slow him down unless you can make him uncomfortable in the pocket.
The Bucs ready for the kickoff. And here we go. It's in the air.
Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field.
As this offense comes back out here, Charles, they're trailing in this ball game, and they've been on the sideline for a while. They did score their last time out, but they just had to watch that long, sustained drive, so we'll see if they can shake the rust off.
Yeah, and that's always a question that you have when you have to come off the bench after having sat there for a long time. Are you ready to go? Are you loosened up? But even more so, are you mentally alert and ready to put your best product out there?
Well, those are the types of plays they probably wish they had made more of in the first 3 quarters. And this deficit is going to be tough to overcome here in the 4th. But a nice first down and a pickup on that throw.
Yeah, and this is where, as coaches, you're looking for effort and execution, even though the scoreboard is going against you.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Credit the sack to Vita Vea.
But one thing I do know, these guys on defense, they don't want this game to end. They're winning by multiple touchdowns. They've shut down the opposing quarterback in a big way, and they're still picking up sacks as we approach the end of this one.
They've got 2nd and 12 from the 36.
Another try after the first down sack. Jackson, throw right side, is complete to Andrews, his tight end.
So it was already a gain on the completion, but tack on some more with that penalty.
Absolutely, and no matter what angle you're making the tackle from, you can't grab the face mask, and that's just putting your defense on its heels just a little bit more.
So a big penalty there on the face mask leads to 1st and 10.
Jackson. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down.
They'll try to draw here with Dobbins.
And they see right through that defensively, as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
When a draw works, it can be a thing of beauty. But when it doesn't, oh, it can be ugly. And in this case, loss of yardage ugly.
Backed up here, tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. Jackson from the shotgun. That's taken in by Duvernay. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards.
A three-score game here late. You can probably rule out the comeback, but certainly some kind of a moral victory to be had if they can get a few more points to close things out. And to that end, a nice pass play there to push things downfield.
Yeah, and we know in this league, a loss is a loss, and no one wants anything to count as a moral victory or, boy, something that feels a little bit cheap. But if they trim that lead down to just two scores, that's still a benefit to this squad.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. An option handoff here to Dobbins. And he's going to get about 4 down inside the 10 to the 9. The 8th play of the drive coming up. It's 3rd and 3. Now it's Jackson. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
Here we go. It's Jackson on 4th down. The quick slant caught. And in for the Ravens' touchdown. Rashad Bateman on the touchdown throw from Lamar Jackson. And the Ravens have got it back to a 2-score game here in the 4th.
So a little bit of a letdown there defensively. I mean, look, you're still 2 scores to the good, CD, but things may be a little more uncomfortable than they had hoped.
Yeah, if you'd kept them out of the end zone there, this game's over. You've locked the door on them. Instead, it's still open a little bit, and they've got a puncher's chance.
Two scores down, 3 timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And the Buccaneers able to recover. Their hands team does its job. Well, 4th quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
53 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now.
And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all 3 still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning.
Now, first down run there for Fournette, but it won't accomplish much as he'll get back only to the line of scrimmage.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Here
they'll run it again with Fournette. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. Now Brady. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Jones. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. A handoff to Fournette. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. They'll give Fournette another crack, and he's in. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Leonard Fournette, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Bucs have opened up a 3-score lead as they pull away here in the fourth. Extra point try now for Sucka. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. The Bucs ready for the kickoff, and here we go. It's in the air. Duvernay going to sit on this in the end zone, so it'll come out to the 25. But now this offense comes back out onto the field. Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out because now it's not a total loss because, as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out-personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
It'll go as a gain of 25 on a play that started back at the 25. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. From midfield now, here's Jackson. He's got his man downfield, that's Bateman. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
It's another first down on a big gainer there, 33 yards.
Defensively, I know they have the comfortable lead here in the fourth, but they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage, and you bring your safeties back. They can pick up anything that leaks through. But in the meantime, upfield, you're making plays on the football.
At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense, they're just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
To throw again on second down, Jackson.
Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
That's coverage you'd expect to see in a tie game late. Not in the lopsided game like this. They are not letting up.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Here's Jackson to throw. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, that was certainly an aggressive call and an aggressive play. Instead of just going for the first down, took the shot in the end zone, went for the touchdown.
And on third down, they said, forget about the sticks. We want six.
Fourth down, here's Jackson. That is caught. It's Bateman for a Raven touchdown. Rashad Bateman with his second touchdown of the night. And the Ravens' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team, but I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film, but this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that'll make this now an 11-point deficit. So two scores down, time definitely not an ally, but here comes the onside kick. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none.
Victory formation now for the Buccaneers. Down to a knee they go.
So he'll take a knee here to wrap this one up, and he's going to want to keep that game ball. He was sensational. So fire the cannons. It's a victory here for Tampa Bay, and they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half to put this one on ice.
And I know a lot of people watching this one are thinking to themselves, I bet halftime was really interesting. I took the paint off the walls with some of the words that were said. But I get the sense that it was much more the adjustments they made. They came in with a game plan that we saw that didn't work in the first half. They made the adjustments necessary, went away from that, and then they got it together, got a spark, and then took off. It's really nice to watch in the second half.